there is this tall man sitting behind a big desk. So you want to be a writer? What's your experience? I said, I have none. You speak with a German accent. Are you from Germany? I said, yes. Were you in Nazi Germany during that time? Yes. And what did you do there? I said, I was fighting Hitler's wars. What was your rank? Platoon leader. And I can read in his eyes. So here he sits, incarnation of evil. These are the guys. And one of them sits right there. I didn't know he was Jewish. That would have been even stronger. Well, he still looks at me, speechless, heading for the door. But before I open up, there comes the thunder voice. Hold it! I can't remember very well the rise of Hitler. It was all a conspiracy of the mind, of the spirit, the extent of which for an American it's almost impossible to comprehend. I hated the military, and that was plain for everybody to see. I was interrogated by Gestapo men about my anti-Nazi attitude, probably made a note in my papers, only used me in suicide attacks, etc. Then we get rid of them that way. They probably knew that half of us would never come back. We were outnumbered. We had a hopeless fight. As it was, almost nobody came back. And the one who should have at least expected to come back was, of course, me. I never knew that I would ever go to America. Then imagine that I would wind up in the middle of the Deep South, in a prisoner of war camp, and then finally taken out of there by the U.S. government as the only one out of 6,000 to send to a school and taught democracy, helping the Americans build a democracy in Germany. Even now, it's almost impossible to imagine that should all have happened to me. But it did.